Hello to our viewers. Welcome back to our channel Key to Band 8 IELTS. So today we are here in front of you with a new task. Now in today's session we'll be talking about an informal letter. Yes, this video is for GT people. For task 1, a letter that is an informal letter. So before starting the video, let me request you all to do subscribe to our channel, hit the like button, share this video with all your GT friends, of course, for the GT people, and tell them that yes, Key to Band 8 IELTS is giving free lessons and they are helping you to write a letter and to score a band of 8. Yes, you heard me right. We'll be telling you how to write your letter to crack a band of 8 in your writing. Okay, so do subscribe guys. So let's start with our task. Now, in today's session, we have an informal letter. Like, what is informal letter? Informal letter is when you are writing a letter to someone who is close to you. Either your friend or a family member or a relative. You know that person personally. So, this is a letter. Your friend gave birth to a baby recently and you bought a present for the newborn. Now, they have given, like in this task, they have given you a situation that your friend, obviously a girl, because she has gave birth to a baby. Okay? So, if a person, here in the exam, if I am a boy, I know I'm writing to someone. You have to mention that your friend is a girl. Okay? Are you getting my point? If a girl is writing down, like I'm a girl, it's very quite simple. But when you are writing down to your female friend, you need to write it accordingly. So here I'll be talking about my female friend who has given birth to a baby recently and I have bought a present for the newborn. Now what are the other subparts of this question? The first subpart is describe what you bought. Okay, so I can, you know, if while planning this task I got an idea that oh my god, what I need to write down, that what kind of gift I can buy. Obviously you are close to that person, she's your friend and you are happy about it, and obviously you will buy some pram thing or a crib or some kind of cradle. If you know, if you have any idea, if you have no idea about the baby's things, like you do not have anyone in your family and you are a kind of least known with the things that are related to baby, you can talk about a baby bag then. Okay, a baby bag which you can carry while traveling with your toddler or your baby. Okay, you can talk about that thing. But here I have talked about a crib. So you decide that gift while you read this thing, because obviously while penning down the ideas in your body paragraph 1 and 2, you need to be very much aware of that thing. If you're talking about a bag, talk about the zips, that it has enormous zips and you can use them, it has a baby, it has a bottle, you can use it to carry your bottles, the milk will not fall because it has perfect, you know, bottle shaped pockets and you can place that bottle in the pockets. So, talk like this. I'll be talking about the crib, and if you are a guy and you do not know anything about the baby, you can talk about toy, you can talk about baby bag, you can talk about pram while, you know, shifting the baby, like you are going to doctor's visit, you obviously need a car seat, a baby car seat, you can talk about that, or you can talk about the pram, that you can easily, you know, lie down the baby in the pram and you can just, you know, take it on the wheels, you can take the baby on the wheels inside the hospital and you do not need to disturb the baby. Once he or she is sleeping, he or she can sleep in that pram. Talk like this. Okay, so you have got an idea how to decide about the present that you have bought for that baby. Then what comes next? Why you choose that present? Obviously before reading the subpart, I've already given you ideas that why. You have already given the reasons, because definitely she is your close friend and you will definitely be giving her about the reasons behind that, why you have opted to buy that present. Now the third part is suggest some arrangements to visit your friend to bring that present. Now here, if you see like here, these two points are being explained like I have explained you. Now if you see this subpart, you'll have an idea that what kind of gift you have to talk about. Suggest some arrangements to visit your friends, like you need some help to visit your friend. Okay, arrangements to bring the present. So this means the gift has to be a big one. It has to be a big one, like a crib. Okay, are you getting my point? Because while if say obviously if you are writing a letter to your friend, your friend is living in another city, while traveling to that city and while carrying that crib, okay, you have to ask her for the arrangements. Like if I say that I'll be coming to your city through subway, if you know, subway is a train in US and London. They call train, like the people who travel through trains, they or metros, they call it subway. Okay, so if you'll be telling her, like you can write down, while I'll be traveling in the subway and I'll be carrying your crib with me, but while I'll reach the airport, while I'll reach your station, like Ludhiana station or Delhi station, I need some help. So I want you to send someone with a car so that I can, you know, that person can help me to carry that crib to your place. Okay, are you getting my point? This is how you will plan your task. Here you will be deciding, like if I was just like, I've read this point, like first point tells me that I have to buy something and I've bought something. I decide I've bought a baby bag. But then comes why you choose that present. I'll give the reasons behind. But this third subpart has actually told me that I need to imagine a big thing because I need arrangements for it. Okay, are you getting my point? This is how, like, read the thing. Read everything that is given in the question. Start imagining. Start putting your ideas into it. Be kind of productive, because in writing tasks, I've already told you in my earlier videos that writing and speaking is somewhere you'll be in your productive skills. You'll be producing something. But for writing and listening, you'll be in your, they'll judge you on your receptive skills. Okay? Receptive skills is whatever you have been given, you are doing something with it. Okay, you are giving answers from whatever is given to you. But here you will be reproducing, you will be producing ideas. So here in the third subpart has already told us that what we need to write down in this task. Okay, so as I've already told you, like for the first part, you can decide, like there be an introduction to this letter. Then comes first body paragraph. You need to decide what subparts you need to cover for your body paragraph 1 and which subpart you will be covering for your body paragraph 2. Now you have an option. Like I've already told you, like do not jump on writing down 3 paragraphs for the 3 subparts. You need to choose 2 for one body paragraph and 1 for the body paragraph 2. Are you getting my point? So what my variation is, I have opted to write down about this, these two in my body paragraph 1, because here I'll be telling about what I have bought, and with the same, in the same paragraph I'll be given my reasons that why I've bought that present. Okay, and for this I'll be talking about that what arrangements I need to, you know, bring that gift into your home. Okay, so am I clear? So let's start our task. Now always in the question there will be given dear --, 99.9% this will be given to you. Okay, if it is not given, then you can write down dear and do not put the comma. If they are given and comma is there, then you need to put down that comma. Like here, dear, I'll write down the name of my female friend. That is, let us say, I'll be writing down dear Anu, comma. Okay. Now, how to start an informal letter? In the informal letter, you need to be casual. Your words has to be casual. You do not need to sound formal. You can talk with excitement. You can talk with expressions in your letter. Here, I have opted to write, like, the starting of this letter is, I hope, like, obviously, in the starting of any letter, like, for especially for the formal letter, you need to ask about the health of that person. So how you can say, like, as here the lady has given your friend, your female friend has given birth to a baby, so you'll ask about her health. Okay, I hope this letter finds you and our beautiful Princess Jia. Obviously, you know, you can talk about the name of the baby. Okay, and you can appreciate or praise the baby girl. Okay, our beautiful Princess Jia in the best of health. Okay, you have talked about their health. Now, next, what comes, you need to congratulate them, because it can be like you have congratulated them on the phone or through WhatsApp or through Facebook post, but still here in the letter you need to congratulate them in the starting. Congratulations to you and Anshul again. Obviously, you are congratulating her again, so you'll write down again. Okay, I am so happy for the three of you. Obviously, you'll, because of the two, not the two of you, now they are family of three, so you'll be writing down, I'm so happy for the three of you. Through this letter, I want to talk about the crib that I have bought for our baby Jia, and you have told the examiner that what this letter will look like. Like I've already told you that in your introduction, like in the first paragraph, you need to tell the examiner that what you will be talking about. And here in this paragraph you have told that you will be talking about the crib that you have bought for the baby. Okay, are you getting my point? Firstly, you will ask about their health. You will congratulate them, because obviously they are new parents. And it's okay. It can be said that you have already congratulated them on WhatsApp, Facebook post, or either on the call. But still, you are writing down a letter, and you know, it shows that you are moving in a decorum. Like you will be asking about their health, you will be congratulating them, and you will be telling that why you are writing down this letter. Okay, so this is now our first subpart is describe what you bought and why you choose that present. Now these two subparts we will be talking about this in our body paragraph 1. I have, like, my variation was that I want to talk about these two in my first body paragraph, so I'll be writing down that only. Now, as you know that obviously, like, the baby, your female friend has given birth recently, and you were so excited that you bought a crib for the baby. So you definitely, it's so normal that you'll explain this excitement to your friend. So I started with this thing only. Like in my body paragraph 2, I've opted to write down about this in my first line only. I reached an ecstatic level as soon as I heard about the arrival of your baby, and you won't believe. Now I have written won't. Yes, you can write down such kind of words in your informal letter. These are not allowed in your formal and semi-formal letters, but you can write such forms of word short, like you would not believe. No, you won't believe. You can talk like this in your informal letters. You won't believe I visited Mimi's store here in Jalandhar the very next day. I have completed the like my first sentence telling her that when I heard about the news of the baby, my energy level reached to a level of excitement and I rushed to Mimi's store in Jalandhar the very next day. Okay? Next, furthermore, add a connector when you will be adding few points like the points that are interrelated. You will be adding connectors to it to add more, furthermore, adding more. Also, I want to add like this. Okay, furthermore, the moment I entered this newborn section, like because here we will be talking about, like we will be talking about that describe what you bought. Now I'll be talking about that I'll be buying the crib and why you choose. Now we will be talking about that. Now I've told her that I visited Mimi's store and the moment I entered this newborn section, my eyes fell on this cute crib. Like you need to describe the crib, not just the crib, but yes, this cute crib. The reason behind this purchase, now as I've already told you, I'll be telling about the reasons of my purchase. So that is the thing I'm writing down. The reason behind this purchase is that it can be converted into a toddler bed. Now what is toddler? Newborns varies from 1 to 2 years. Toddlers are from 4 plus age. Toddlers, those are called toddlers. So they say that it can be, the crib can be converted into a toddler bed, which means it can accommodate Jia till the age of 10. So I've given a beautiful reason that why I've opted to buy a crib for Jia. Are you getting my point? I've given one important reason that why I've bought this particular crib is that it can accommodate Jia, it can be converted into a bed and it, you can use it up till Jia becomes 8 or turns 10. Okay? Now what, now have a look. I have written, isn't that great? I have added, as it is an informal letter, you can talk like this. You can show your excitement. You can actually tell that yes, she is one of your close friend. Obviously, you are not buying a crib for a stranger. Crib is an expensive thing and you are not buying it for an or for a stranger or a very random friend. She is your best friend and or a more than a friend to you. And you can talk like this. Isn't that great? Now, what more reason you can add is one more thing. Like again, I've told you furthermore, you can write down adding more. Like here, I've opted to use one more thing. I want to add is that the crib is of white color. White color, you're talking about the crib now. And it will look perfect in the nursery. Now, what is nursery? Nursery is the room for the babies. Like for the newborn room is called a nursery. So you are saying that it will look perfect in the nursery. I remember you told me that you guys have painted nursery white, so they will synchronize easily. You have given two reasons for it. One reason, it can be like the crib becomes a bed and you can use that crib up till age of 10, and the crib is of white color and you told me, like your female friend has told you once on the phone, that they have painted nursery white, so it will synchronize easily. So that's it. You have explained these two points so dramatically and you have added emotions into it. You have added connectors. You have used compound sentences because you are not talking like this, full stop, this. Full stop, this. No, you're not talking like this. You are adding two points and adding them because, although you're adding such things into your lines in your sentences and you're writing down it so beautifully and you're mentioning compound sentences in your body paragraph. Okay, so you are there, like this task up till here, your task up till here has coherence and cohesion, because you everything is synchronizing with each other, like they are interrelated. Now there is task achievement. You have explained this, you have explained these two things perfectly. This I do not feel that there is something left, that yes, the child can add some more things into it. No, you have completely written everything. Up till here we have written down everything and we have explained it also. Now in the last we will be talking about suggest some arrangements to visit your friend to bring the present. If you see here, lexical resources, we talk about our lexical resources. We have not repetitively used any word. Okay, if we were talking about this Mimi store, but here I've talked about this newborn section. I'm not repetitively using the same word, store. I visited this store. The store has a lot of cribs. I've used new words. Now if we talk about grammatical range, then I have vocabulary. If we talk about vocabulary words, I have used various vocabulary words. Now let me see that we have talked about crib, we have talked about toddler bed, we have talked about synchronizing, we have talked about that the purchase, like I'm not saying I'm buying it, obviously purchase is a vocabulary word and I'm using that word for it. Okay, so next comes, I've talked about the arrival of your baby. I'm not talking Princess Jia again and again. I'm rather using Princess Baby, our baby, Baby Jia, right? I'm not repetitively writing down our beautiful Princess Jia, our beautiful Princess Jia. No, I'm not talking in that way. So this adds to your lexical resources, your vocabulary, that you have good hold on your vocabulary and you are not repetitively using the same words again and again. Okay, so now let's jump on to our second part of this video, that is body paragraph 1 and signing off thing. Now let's talk about the body paragraph 2. In the body paragraph 2, we'll be talking about some arrangements that we need from our friend. I was wondering if next weekend would be fine to visit you? So obviously you will be visiting her. So you'll be talking about the visit first. Like at what time or which weekend you can visit your friend to meet Jia, her daughter, and to present her the gift that you have bought for her. So you'll be talking like, I was wondering if next weekend would be fine. Would be fine to visit you? Here, like this, we have added and question interrogative sentence form in our task one only. So can you see the difference that we have mentioned compound sentences? We have mentioned added connectors, and now in body paragraph 2. We are adding a question interrogative sentence form that will add a benefit on your band score. Like you will be given 9 bands on your task. Up till here you will be given 9 because you are writing down like your task is in a proper way. There is cohesion and coherence in your task. You know what to write in your body paragraphs. You are going well in your task achievement. When we talk about lexical resources, you are using new words for your lexical resources. When we talk about grammatical range, you are adding different forms of sentences also. You are using connectors also. So who can stop you to crack a band of 9 on your writing task 1? Okay, so next what we need, what we want to tell the friend is that we need some help. We'll be talking about that now. Also, I'll be taking subway from my city, and while I reach Ludhiana station, I want you to send Anshul in his car so that we can easily bring the present at your place. So easily, I have explained that I want your husband to come in his car to pick me from the station so that I can bring the present easily at your place. adding more. Again, I'm adding a connector here. I will book an installation visit by Mimi team to put the bed together for our daughter. Obviously, now as here, if I'll be writing up till here, don't you feel that my body paragraph 2 was lacking behind ideas? Won't the examiner feel that, oh my god, the student has finished it so easily that I want your husband to come to pick me, that these are the arrangements? You can talk something more about it. You can talk that the crib I'm talking, it is not assembled, I'm carrying it in a box. Okay, obviously the crib will be in the box, you won't be carrying the crib like this. So you'll be asking, you have made an installation visit by the Mimi team because you are buying it from a branded store. So you'll be asking the team to give a visit in Ludhiana to assemble this crib at your friend's place. Okay, so you need to add ideas to crack a band of 9. Okay, so you'll be writing down that I will book. I will book means like the moment you will tell me that when to visit your home, because here you have just asked your friend that when I can visit, like I can visit on weekends, like wondering if next weekend, on the coming weekend, I'm free. This shows that you are free and you want her approval to tell you that yes, you can come. Then I will be booking an installation visit by Mimi team to put the bed. Again, you are not using the same word crib, but the U word bed. Okay, together for our daughter. Again, you are not writing baby princess, baby G, or you are just writing down our daughter, because obviously she is close to you. You can talk that she is just like my daughter. My daughter, please let me know what time would be more convenient to you for the installation. Obviously, the installation, you'll be going to her home. It doesn't mean that at the same time the installation person from the Mimi team will come. No, you are asking her that give me any idea that what time is, you know, suitable for you, like at what time Gia will be sleeping and then you can look after the installation. So you want that, give me, like provide me with the more convenient to you, like at what time will be more convenient to you for the installation. Please contact me on my new number 99999, as my previous number is not working. Okay, so this shows that this is also one of the reason that why you are writing down a letter to her, because your old number is not working and you want her to contact you on your new number. Hoping to see you soon. Like here, the closing line has to be like this only, because you will be meeting them. You will be meeting her soon. Yours lovingly. Lovingly is always used for an informal letter. Gunveet. Do not write down Kaur or your surname in an informal letter. Just write down your first name and no date. No date. In semi-formal and informal, it is mandatory to write down the date, but in an informal letter, you do not need to write down a date. Always start from the left margin. Between the paragraphs, leave one line. Always start from the extreme. Always start your paragraph from the extreme left. That's it. And we promise, like Key to Band 8, I'll promise you that if you will be following these steps while writing down your letter, nobody can stop you to crack a band of 8 on your writing. We give a margin, like if I'm not saying 9, doesn't mean you will be not given 9 on this writing task, but still students may you know make mistakes. So we give a margin that if there is some spelling mistake, or when you are writing down, like I always use capital font while I practice in my videos, like I'm telling you, because I want you to have a closer look. I want you to understand my language. That is the reason I use capital font. But in your exam, use cursive font or or the regular font. Okay, do not just jump into writing down the capital, but a normal one. Like whenever you start your paragraph, the first letter has to be capital. When you are using comma, after comma, you need to again use the capital letter. The first letter has to be capital one. And when you put a full stop, again after that, like full stop, then again the capital letter. Like this, you need to write down. Like have these ideas in your have. Look after these points while writing down your task, and nobody can stop you to crack a band of 8 on your writing. So always add sentence forms, add compound sentences, add question interrogative sentence, add passive sentence, add compound sentences. Obviously, like there are 5 types of sentences. If you will be adding those 5 types of sentences in your task too, like we suggest that you need to add just 2 types of sentences in your letters, and then the rest of the, like all the 5 sentence forms in your writing task too, then you can easily crack a band of 8, because we do not want you to put a pressure, like you to have a pressure on your head that, oh my god, while writing down a letter I need to add sentence forms. No, do not just jump into writing down. Still try. If you can add, try your level best. If not, then we'll give a try in our writing task too. Then also you will be given good marks or good bands on your writing. So, this is me, Gunveet, signing off for today. Bye-bye.